I'm Flux Pavilion, and we're here in Miami for a WMC, doing the whole pool party thing. But yeah, not currently, obviously. We're indoors, but yeah. We just put out an album, essentially, with Circus. It's been a while since we've done something of the size of Grand Central. But yeah, we've like got all our guys together on the label back in the office. And yeah, so this album's been the first kind of step towards Circus Records like it used to be, like a good few years ago. Yeah, so all kind of like, as everything blew up, we all just like had so much stuff to do. But now it's cool, we could sort of sit down and work out like where the label's going, what directions we want to take it in, and sort of just kind of spread it all out. And yeah, this album's the first step towards that. To pick yourself up, you got to jump up high. You got to pick yourself up, you got to jump up high. You got to pick yourself up. The label head over at Circus, Andrew, really wanted to do something for Miami. And then we were talking about like titles for the EP, and then Grand Central came up. And I was like, yeah, you do know there is a venue in Miami called Grand Central. And we're like, sweet, let's book it. We booked that for the album launch. Putting together like a new record at the minute. So I've just kind of rebuilt my studio at home. I used to use KRK RP6s. I've been using those for about 4 years, but I just got some of the Adams S3X, which yeah, they're really cool. And I got a Neve 33609 and a TK Audio BC1 mix bus. And then two preamps, I've had them built. They're the first two made by these new guys. And it's like a six band EQ, a limiter and a compressor and a tube preamp. I've got two of those mono so I can have a stereo to use it as a mix bus as well. And when it comes to the stage of actually putting together a full project, I think having that kind of equipment does help. But a lot of the times I've just been going into studios, and you can book out studios or sort of send stuff off to mixers and mastering engineers and stuff. But I like having the control of being able to do it myself and being able to just, if I need to make a last minute adjustment, I can just do it. Go in 1 a.m, I've got all my gear there and I can just do it all myself. Been using Cubase since I started, pretty much, and there's not much that really annoys me about it. I can do whatever I want to do, I can do it really easily. But my main production laptop died a few weeks ago, so all I've got is Ableton. I use it when I'm putting together stuff for my sets. So like, if I've got a track at 132 BPM, and I can use Ableton to make it go from 132 to 128 to 175 and make edits. So for when I play, I can like have a lot more fun with tempos and stuff. I just want to play music, really. If a song works, then a song works. Obviously, the great thing about DJing is the art of presenting music to people in a way that they maybe haven't heard it before, which is the cool thing with edits and like working out mixes to get from that track through these tracks. Sometimes makes the final destination so much more euphoric, which is cool about DJ sets. But I don't kind of delve into it that much. If I want a track to build up and drop really hard, I'll write that track. I'm always getting emails and always getting stuff sent over. And then every now and then, every couple of weeks, I'll just put a whole bunch of tracks on my memory stick and then play them. I tend to do it more after parties, is the sort of general testing ground where I'll just kind of piss about, do whatever, play tracks that I really like, see how they work, try them in different places. Then for a big set, when it's like a huge festival thing, I'll have a better, stronger idea of the best way to work stuff. Latest technology. DJs to memory sticks, so much easier than CDs. The process of trying to hit cues, if I've got a really good mix lined up, and I'm trying to hit cues with CDJs, I'm like, I'll make sure I've got, because I always had just like two tracks on a CD, so I'd constantly be going through my CD wallet. I only DJ as a means of performance. The only way, as a producer, you can really perform your music easily is by DJing. Until I can somehow work out how to capture the energy with a live band, which is something I'm working on, but I've been holding on to it for a bit because I want it to be right. It's the most important thing. If I just go out there with a live act, it needs to be as good as a DJ set. Well, not just as good as a DJ set, but better. Otherwise, I might as well just do a DJ set. That's the whole kind of process behind that. Only with a vocalist or a writer will I like to sit in a studio. But if I'm working with another producer, I always prefer just the time on my own because it's kind of all the process of rolling through ideas and rolling through things and kind of cutting stuff out. I tend to just do things and then delete everything, do it all again, delete everything all again until all my sound palette has shifted enough that it's all quite strong and it sounds quite nicely produced, and then what I write. Unless I do something really good in the first 5 minutes, I'm like, cool, I'll hold on to that. And when there's another person in the room, that process just doesn't work as well, because it's kind of like when you're sitting there and you're making a horrible sound or a horrible noise or it sounds really bad, and you know it sounds really bad, that's cool when it's just me, because I'm like, cool, it's my process to get it to sounding good. But when there's another person sitting there who's a producer, who knows the process that I'm going through, it just makes it a bit more uncomfortable, I find. Whereas with a vocalist, it's the process of you're talking about lyrics and structure and melody and more compositional kind of stuff, which is better to be sitting in a room with, I think, and making a connection for that. Enjoy it, really, is the fundamental thing. And try not to use your ears too much and use your emotions, because that's where your inspiration is, just kind of a lot of the time, I like that, I want to write something that sounds like that. But I try not to look at it like that. I look at a track and go, I like that. I want to write something that makes me feel like that track makes me feel. Because then if you're trying to copy someone's vibe and draw from someone's vibe, but your track won't sound anything like this. If I'm trying to write like a Bob Marley record, if I'm like, oh, that's really cool, then if I'm using my ears, I'll just start writing reggae. But if I'm using my gut, who knows what it's going to sound like. But the one fundamental thing is it will feel like that Bob Marley record makes me feel. And that's how I've written since I was a kid. And it kind of has worked out for me. So yeah, it's a tip that I'd give to anyone new. Because I think it's something that people don't think about so much.
Welcome to Dubspot. We believe in providing you hands-on experience right away. Whether you're completely new to music and want to turn the sounds in your head into a musical reality, or you're an experienced artist looking to refine your skills and add new tools to your arsenal, we're ready to meet you at your level. For students of all ages, all levels, and all styles of music, Dubspot is here to help you achieve your goals. With course offerings both online wherever you are and at our school in the heart of New York City, we are ready to guide you through the next phase of your musical transformation. Whether you want to produce music, DJ, or do both, you've come to the right place. Come explore Dubspot for yourself. Become a part of our community and make music.